Today we begin our series on home building. So the first part of the series, I'm just going to cover how the building process, how you kind of get into it, how you begin the process. As always, find a great realtor, me. Second, get pre-approved with a great lender. I have many that I work with. I can specialize my referral depending on kind of what you want to do. When you're looking to get pre-approved to build a home, it kind of depends on what you're looking for. There are two ways that you can finance it. Well, there are probably other ways, but these are the two most popular. The first you can do is just do it like any other normal home purchase. So the builder carries the building and the construction loan, and then you just close on closing day, the loan goes into your name, just like any other purchase. The second way you can do it is by carrying the construction loan yourself. Now there are definitely benefits to both of these depending on what you're looking for. If you're to carry your own construction loan, typically what they do is you get loaned the money for the building part, the builder does his part, and in stages then we'll send you bills and you send out the money. The bank will then give you that money, you send it out back to the contractors. A benefit of carrying your own loan also is you're able to deduct the interest yourself. So those are kind of the two main ways to go about it. I would say the most popular way is to have the builder carry the loan, especially probably up until you get into those higher end price points. So that's the very first thing you want to do is get pre-approved. Same with buying a house. Once you're ready to go, you get taken a lot more seriously. Some builders won't even price out a home for you unless they know you can purchase it. So it just saves everybody a lot of time. Pre-approvals are good for 90 days. Typically, a home probably will take longer than 90 days to build. So all that you'll have to do is the lender will have to re-pull your credit. Most of the time, that's going to be the exact same as it was. As always, I don't recommend quitting your job, buying a new car, opening any new lines of credit. So it should be the same thing, they re-pull it, and you go on. Now the tough part, how do you decide where to build and who to use? So there are two different kind of homes, well there's kind of three, I guess. So your normal spec home is a home that a builder builds, they choose the plan, they choose the selections inside, they just build it and sell it at that point. You don't really have any customization, it just is what it is. Sometimes, if you can get in early enough on that spec house, then you can maybe pick some of the selections. So if the house isn't quite done, you might be able to pick the flooring color, the paint color, those kinds of things. Then you also have what we call built to orders. So those are homes that are plans by the builder where the structure pretty much is already taken care of, but then you get to choose all the selections. So you get to choose anything, well, really anything. You would sit down with most builders, go over the floor plan, move walls, etc. Of course, some of those changes add money to the cost. So a build to order is a way that if you're on a tight budget, you know you like that plan, you've been through it, you've walked through it, you just might want to choose your own colors, your own cabinets, etc. Then you can sit down and do that. So when you sit down, like I said, you choose your cabinets, your flooring, your paint, your light fixtures, and most builders, what they will have for you are a few choices. So for example, you could go in and they'll say, okay, these five cabinet colors are what you have to select from. If you don't like those, you of course can go choose something else, but everything costs money. So that's kind of how the built to order works. And then you kind of go up from there to a fully custom home where you can do that a different couple ways too. You can again choose your plan and maybe tweak it, enlarge it, shrink it, move some walls, things like that. Or you can do it from scratch where you design your plan with an architect, you find a builder, and then you start that process from there. So there's a few different ways. I would say different price points kind of bring along different commonalities in those. Most of the time, you know, under that $400 to $500, you're probably looking at a spec or a built to order. Kind of when you get above the $400 is kind of when it makes some more sense to maybe do a custom and get things exactly how you want. Again, not to say you can't make changes on those customs or built to orders, but that's kind of how it works. So that's kind of how you choose your plan. However, let me take a step back because before you choose a plan, you might want to choose a builder. So in Des Moines, it is very common that the builders own certain lots. And so if you fall in love with a lot, you may have to build with that builder. Not all lots are that way, but a lot of them are, a majority are. So when you're looking for lots, you can have your realtor, me, send you land available for sale. There's, again, many things that you can look into for a lot. There's three basic kinds of lots. There's a flat lot, where your basement would just have egress windows, which are mandatory for it to count as a bedroom. There are daylight lots, which are lots where the windows in the basement, at least on one side, are fully above ground. And then there are walkout lots. And of course, that's where you have a door to walk out to the main level, or to the backyard or lower level, I should say. So those are kind of the lots you can find. And then of course you have ones that back to trees, backs to creeks, corner lots. I will say corner lots typically add a little bit more money. Usually pricing wise, it goes flat lots are the least expensive, then daylight lots, and then walkouts. Corner lots, you can always plan on adding, probably depending on the size, another $5,000 to $10,000 for the extra sidewalk. So when you do own a corner lot, you're responsible for both sides of that corner. So those are typically the kind of lots. Again, drive around, look for areas you like. If they are listed available for lots only, they will say bring your own builder or you must use our builder. So that's kind of where some people want to use a specific builder, but they don't have that lot listed. Occasionally you'll see builders trade lots and work together on that. It just kind of depends. Of course, if it's considered a really good popular lot, they're not probably going to do that. Once you find a lot, then of course you get the builder involved. So to choose a builder, again, it's kind of like a lot. You can go choose your builder. You can choose a plan you like and then use that builder. But touring homes to see what kind of finishes they produce. You can go interview builders. Builders will price out certain plans for you. So if it's a plan of theirs that you like, they can definitely price that for you. Again, depending on if it's a spec house or a custom house, it might take a while. They don't usually have all plans priced for what current pricing is. Just depends on your size of builder too. If it's a builder that builds 20 homes a year, it might take a little longer to price something out. If it's a builder who builds 100 plus homes a year, they probably have all that pricing and then a la carte things that you can add in and out that makes it really simple and quick. So after that, depending on the builder you choose, then of course you choose your house plan. Again, it could be reversed. So when you choose a plan, you have to make sure that it fits on your lot. So if you have a rather small lot and you want to build a big ranch home, it may not work. It may be too wide for the lot. Generally speaking, ranch homes cost more to build than two-story homes. With ranch homes, you're building out. With two-story, you're building up. So in general, you can kind of think of it that way. According to pricing, when you kind of try and think of like what your lot costs should be to the ratio of your home, typically they generally say that a home will end up being about four times the cost of your lot. So not always the rule, but most of the time that's kind of what you can plan on. So those are kind of the first steps to get started as far as picking your lot, getting financed. We have a lot of great local banks that specialize in construction loans. And there's, you know, a ton of builders. So it always pays to have a great realtor to know who are some of the builders that, you know, stand above the rest. You know, they're, you can count on them to come back and fix things. They're easy to work with. That being said, it's not impossible to get through a building situation and not have any issues at all. Of course, some issues arise. They could be out of the total control of the realtors, the builder, but most of the time it should be a really good experience for you, as building a home is nerve-wracking. But, so those are just the steps to get started. So stay tuned for the next phase of our video series.